saying, the early bird catches the worm, but I've got a feeling this time in the morning, this being January, the worm's going to be frozen. Anyway, I'm out with Joe.
Morning.
Yeah. If you can see him. And I often get asked about Joe, where's Joe gone? Well, Joe's now called Wessex Photography. He was the Hoop Bivvy Wild Camper. Say my feet are warm and dry, but we're making our way across now to the King's Name Lane, which is featured in previous videos on this channel, and then we've got to be quiet because we're heading on to more farmland where we think the deer are. Again, very muddy underfoot. Walking along Kingsdown Lane. We've come out, that was a wet old go through that Stratton Wood part of the journey there. We're gonna have to start being quiet now. I had to put this camera onto silent mode, so as I started up just now, I thought it's not working. Anyway, hopefully it is. Anyway, have a look at Kingsdown Lane. We're making our way across now to a nice woodland, fairly remote, which is known, I've nicknamed it the Forbidden Wood. We're hoping there'll be some deer over there. And certainly it's a bit off the beaten path, and so there's going to be less human activity. So fingers crossed we'll see some more wildlife. Also, there's a favourite part of the wood. We're going to go through the Forbidden Wood to the other side, and there's another little woodland there. Joe reckons it's the ideal place for a brew up as well, so I brought the stove with me. That'll be something to look forward to. It is cold this morning. Well, we just managed to see some wildlife. We've got a fox just across the way. This camera won't show it. It's over there. I've got the long lens on my G7, and that has picked him up quite well, so I'll put some of that footage in for you now. Well, another bit of luck, just walking along the path here, and then Joe suddenly stops and points over into the field, and then we've got a small group of deer. Managed to get the long lens on the G7 onto the deer again, but the autofocus wasn't working. It was picking up the hedge in the foreground, so I had to quickly switch to manual focus and do the best I could to hurriedly get the shot of the deer. Just had a bit of a bonanza. Just turned a corner, looked ahead, and about 150 yards in front of us, there looks to be I'd say it's a roe doe from here. Can't quite see it that clearly. I've got the other camera trained on it, so we'll see what that image comes out like. Looking like that, isn't it? I'll tell you what though, it's so cold. Taking my gloves off just for a minute. Bitter, isn't it?
That finger. Because I've got these gloves where you can take the fingers off, so you can still operate your camera.
Yeah, yeah.
But that finger, I can't feel it.
It's bitter cold, isn't it? The ground, I'm not kidding, the ground's iron hard, it's freezing. Just saw what we didn't want to see. We come into the wood and it's absolutely perfect. Look at this, look. It's a beautiful woodland. I said to Joe, if we're warm here, we're in the lee of the trees. The deer were all, there was a small group of deer. And then suddenly they all got up and ran. Seconds later, followed by a black dog. Much as I love dogs, you've got to control them. There's certain times when you can let them off the lead, and there's certain times when you keep them on the lead. And this is one of the places where you want your dog on a lead. It's not fair on the wildlife. We're heading towards a small copse now. Ideal place for a brew, so Joe says. You've been there before, Joe, have you?
Yeah, I've walked through there quite a few times. Just want to show you a couple of the wild camping spots in there.
Yeah,
it might be good
potential for some future wild camps, possibly. The best way to prime these stoves, Joe, is to get your fuel. I've got some Coleman fuel in there. I'll just trickle it down the burner. And then ignite it. That's basically the petrol. So that preheats it. This is the best way I found to prime it. You wouldn't want to do it inside your tent, would?
No.
There's a on top of the reservoir. There's a little depression where the fuel gathers, and that you can see it's gathered in there now. And it's now priming it heats the whole thing up.
Oh right, a bit like a preheater on my winter stove then. It's got a little loop up by the burner.
That's it. She's now going.
That's quite quick, hasn't it?
Yeah. Well, I can tell you that brew hit the spot. We're now walking out of the woodland. Yeah, nice piece of woodland this. I should be back here. We're going to see what we can see, then possibly we'll be heading back home. It's a bit rough going here. Yeah, we've had a lot of rain. This is this part of the land. It's well off the beaten track, and there's no sign of human activity, more animal tracks and trails than anything else. So yeah, a delightful piece of woodland. I'm really enjoying this winter's walk. There's not many waterfalls in my neck of the woods. And we're walking along the path, well, along the field by the side there, and we heard the sound of running water, made our way down through the brush, and we got a lovely waterfall. I think we're finally headed home now, but we did stay a while here, played with the cameras. Joe got his Nikon out and took some nice SDR images. Don't forget to check out Joe's channel. I'll put a link in the description to that. I think he's doing some really good stuff on his Nikon at the moment. It's a D7500, Joe, isn't it?
Yeah.
I've tried HDR on this as well, at that oak tree there. It is quite flat light, so don't expect anything brilliant. It is good fun though. So anyway, this is going to draw this video to a conclusion. Time to head off back home now, get home in time for lunch. We've had a good morning out. We left home at 7 and it's now midday, so it was nice to come out into the nature and get some lovely footage. That waterfall was spectacular. I was pleased about that. Anyway, we're heading back home now this way. So thanks for watching. And I'll see you in the next video. Bye for now.